With the release of the Archon story surrounding Kazuha, we have gathered a lot of information that needs to be digested. And with all these infos, we can put up three possible theories that I will cover in this video. As it covers the most recent part of the story, there will be huge spoilers, so please turn this video off if you don't want to ruin your own curiosity. Also, please keep in mind that these predictions are based on game content only. I followed the story and my writer's brain felt challenged to put up a web with predictions and small theories. This point is something I actually thought very long about. It is the first part of the newest quest. If we take the last quest into our consideration, it is very clear that our sibling is not interested in joining us right now. But the clearest thing is, the sibling is also no direct threat to us. In the Mondstadt arc, most people should have gotten to the conclusion sibling has joined the bad guys and we need to stop them. But when both met, it became clear that we couldn't be further away from the truth. But what does that mean for the relationship between the siblings? For this, we need to explore something writers call a trope. Tropes are something like a stereotype in storytelling. But also, it is almost impossible to tell a story without using a trope. We will take a closer look to the so-called Cain and Abel trope. There is also the sibling rivalry trope, but that covers almost just the competition between the siblings. Cain and Abel is a trope where one part of the sibling turns evil. Despite the name, the trope just ends with sibling murder in the worst case. We don't have to expect this from our traveler siblings. While the sibling joined the Abyss Order, they don't seem to be hostile, almost welcoming and waiting for the moment the sibling finds out the truth and decides for themselves what is good and wrong. What the relationship of the two is bringing exactly is determined by the future. With more updates and quests regarding the Abyss Order, we will get more information and also more options to determine the path the both are wandering. And regarding mysteries, this will lead us to the next part. When it comes to the origin of Paimon, there are many theories in the internet. Even I saw many of them, and almost everyone sounded plausible. But nothing is more shrouded in mystery than her origins. But then Kazuha mentioned something that got me thinking. While talking during the Archon quest, he said while looking at Paimon, "And not to mention your incredibly complex scent, like that of some mysterious being." Also, while talking about how the traveler learned to channel the elemental energies, he told Kazuha that it was all thanks to Paimon. So Paimon is a being that knows exactly how to channel elemental energy through the body and not focused through a vision, like all other beings, including the Archons, who channel their power through their gnosis. While we didn't learn anything about the real origin of Paimon, we gained precious knowledge. Unfortunately, not enough knowledge to form a solid theory or a story prediction about it right now. first thing that came to my mind during this scene was literally, dude, we can't do that yet. We haven't collected the power of Electro now. And if we take a logical approach on it right now, then it's pretty obvious. Through touching a statue of the Seven, we gather the ability to wield the power of the god. What is sure is that we don't know the complete scale of the traveling sibling's true power. But if we take a look at the recent events, and it's sure the travelers are not to mess with, always keep in mind that the sibling planned to create a mechanical god that could rival the gods in Celestia himself. The sibling even wanted to use the remnants of a literal god for this plan. Also, they mentioned that the traveler should finish their journey like he or she has done before. This means that the sibling has also gathered elemental powers, and according to the color on their clothes indicates that they got their original power back. But what is the point I want to reach with this story? It's simple. To restore the power bestowed by a single god, we would need at least the same power. Since the traveler at this point hasn't gathered the Electro element, the vision will not respond to him. In the last months, I learned the following. When it comes to Genshin Impact storytelling, it's pretty impossible to predict the story in the long run. We got small bites of story to run our minds about, but in the end, it throws up more questions than answers. Right now, I can only predict some little things. First of all, there will be a Fatui Harbinger encounter in Inazuma. The Tsaritsa is after the gnosises of the other Archons, and she certainly doesn't want to miss out this opportunity. Also, our arrival in Inazuma will stir up many sources of trouble, which serves as a good distraction for the Fatui to sneak in also. Who knows, maybe we are already tailed by them. Second, the Abyss Order is not our enemy. Since the first part, finding the sibling, for the journey is completed, there are questions to be answered. The gods have their share of secrets too, and the traveler wants answers. So it's pretty hard to sort the Abyss Order into a category. I guess this will be a huge part in later story quests, since it forces us to choose sides. Since our sibling is basically the leader of the Abyss Order, it could really damage the traveler's reputation and friendships along the way, making them an outcast in most of the nations. Story-wise, I'm pretty hyped for the release of Inazuma, because it will reveal new story developments and deliver puzzle parts for our story prediction to put together. Maybe with the release of the next Archon quest, we will be able to harness everything we need. As always, it was a real pleasure that you joined me today, and I hope you enjoyed your stay. If you liked my story prediction, then it would be really nice to leave a like. Please keep in mind that these predictions are always based on my own experiences in the game and informations I gather. I'm a human being and not perfect in any way. If you find some major errors and flaws in my predictions, just leave a comment and we could discuss it there. Until then, stay safe and have a nice day. Bye bye.